Blaze and Joan. Here's my mommy and daddy from FM Smith.
But you'd do the same if you were in my shoes. So tell me I'm wrong and leave my worries behind. I know you've been drinking down at Duffy's bar. I found the gold earring in the back of your car. A woman phoned here, I gave her a fright. She told me she'll meet you tomorrow night. And the money's all gone from the cookie jar.
Well, let me explain, it's so easy to do. Let me explain, I can show it to you. Let me explain, I'll have to rack my brain. But let me explain.
Please do.
I took the money from the cookie jar.
I figured that.
The woman that phoned here, I'm buying you her car. The earring belongs to your Aunt Louise. I drove her to church, it fell off when she sneezed. And the boys at Duffy's,
yeah,
have all seen your scar. So you tell me.
Let me explain, the reason is clear. Let me explain, they're all doctors, my dear. Let me explain, well that's what they claim. Let me explain.
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 This court is now in session. Judge Vilma H. Bunny Davidson presiding.
Will the defendant please approach the bench? Will you tell the court your full name and occupation, please?
Yes. My name is Thomas Thomas Raphael blank blank Shrift hyphen Huntington exclamation point no onions ing the third. I'm an exchange student studying to become an unskilled laborer.
Fine. Mr. Ng, you have been
or
charged...
Or Mr. Third. You could call me Mr. Third.
Mr. Third.
Or Mr. Ng. Either one.
You have been charged with first-degree murder and illegal parking.
Yes, that's right.
And how do you plead?
Well, it depends. Usually, time of day. I'd say most of the time on my knees.
Guilty or innocent?
Guilty, guilty, innocent, guilty. Just have the two flavors, do you? Guilty and innocent.
No, as a matter of fact, we have guilty with an explanation.
Oh, that sounds kind of interesting. Can I hear the explanation first?
Didn't you read your script? I mean, it's explained fully in the script. Now, we make up the crimes and rent me this outfit, but you're supposed to prepare the explanation.
Well, I certainly wish that had been explained to me. They called my agent. We negotiated a fee for my appearance here. But nobody ever mentioned, you know, making up an explanation.
Well, I'm sorry, Mr. Ng, but those are the rules.
Well, that's okay. I plead guilty.
No. No. You can't plead guilty. You see, we have allowed 5 minutes for your explanation.
Well, I don't care. I mean, nobody told me to prepare an explanation. My agent didn't advise me to prepare an explanation. My contract says nothing about an explanation. I don't care about your problems, all right? I pleaded guilty. Now just give me the electric chair and my check and let me get out of here, Your Honor.
Very well, Mr. Ng. I find you not guilty with an explanation.
Oh, that sounds kind of good. Well, let's have a hear on the explanation then, Smarty. Or, Your Honor. Your Smarty Honor.
In light of the fact that neither your agent, nor your manager, nor your local ACTRA representative informed you that you were to prepare an explanation, and this alone...
Sorry, it's a twitch, Your Honor.
This and this alone caused you to plead not guilty. And due to the recent...
I didn't plead not guilty, Your Honor. I pleaded guilty. I just wanted my check and I wanted to hit the road here. You're pleading not guilty with an explanation. Didn't you read your script?
This caused you to plead guilty.
Guilty, yes.
And due to the recent energy crisis, we are no longer allowed, unfortunately, to electrocute you for pleading guilty.
I was kind of looking forward to that to myself. I said I'd get a charge when I came down here. Your Honor, nice glasses.
And due to the fact, Mr. Ng...
Mr. Third.
Due to the fact
or
that...
Or Tom. Call me by my second Tom. Tom, if you like. Do I have to drum this into you, Your Honor?
Due to the fact, Mr. Ng, this is not a comedy show, you know.
Oh.
Due to the fact...
Yes?
...that accepting your plea of guilty would have made the show 5 minutes short, I find you not guilty.
Do you have any clothes on under that? Oh, look, just give me my check, eh? And I'll maybe meet you in the parking lot.
Very well. Here's your check, Mr. Ng. You won't be back. Next.
See you later, Tubby.
Let me explain all the jokes of today.
Let me explain, can be reasoned away.
Let me explain, I'm legally insane.
Let me explain.
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 Thank you, Bunny.
Thank you. And please welcome our real good friend, Althea DiGregorio.
Don't you close your eyes the moment you close the light, to be rid of all the feelings, how they cluttered up the morning, to be free of all those memories, everyone. Take another. Isn't loneliness a winner? Was leaving me the best thing you've ever done? To be rid of all the feelings, how they cluttered up the morning, to be free of all those memories, everyone. Take a bow, then take another. Here's a loneliness, a winner. Was leaving me the best thing you've ever done.
Life of a handyman.
This is an educational record designed to teach you how to perform simple woodworking techniques.
That's why I got it.
First of all, have all the tools spread out in front of you on the workbench.
I have all the tools spread out in front of me here.
Well then, aren't you a wonderful person? Now just take a couple of minutes and familiarize yourself with all of the tools.
Hello, tools. Ruler, saw, nice teeth.
On the floor in front of you is a 5-foot piece of 2x2.
How did you know that?
Take your tape measure and mark off 4'6" on this board.
How many centimeters is that? Must be an American elbow.
Now put the board in the vise before you saw it.
I can't do it before I saw it. I already seen it.
Before we use any tool,
yeah,
we must put on our safety goggles.
Yep.
Do we have our safety goggles?
I have mine. I think you left yours at the record store.
Safety goggles protect us from injury.
Yes.
Now pick up the saw.
I can't see very well.
Put your safety goggles on.
Well, I had them on. I can't see very well.
And cut the board at the line. Start slowly and take smooth, even strokes. By now, you should be about halfway through. Put those goggles on.
I can't see with the goggles on.
There. Now you have cut all the way through the board.
I'm quite...
This edge may seem a bit rough right now, but you can sand it smooth later. Put your safety goggles back on.
I can't see very well.
Now get the drill and drill a straight, even hole in the center of the board. Good. Put your safety goggles back on.
You got a safety helmet.
Now get a nail and hammer it into the board.
I can't find it.
Put your safety goggles back on.
I can't see it.
Try to hit the nail dead on. Put the goggles on.
But not when I have the...
A glancing blow will bend it and mar the finish of the wood.
Yeah.
Put those goggles on.
I can't see.
And hit the nail very, very hard.
Okay. Okay. I did it. I got the goggles on. What now? What's this going to be? A stick? Must be another album. The man's a genius. Here's Morag.
I know you don't know what I'm going through. Standing here looking at you. Well, let me tell you that it hurts so bad. It makes me feel so sad. It makes me hurt so bad to see you again. Like needles and pins, people say he's been making out all. I do anything you want me to. You loved me before, please love me again. I can't let you go back to her. Please don't go, please don't go. Please
Comedy Club this week to see Mark Halloran.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, our leader. So what's going on? You know, what's happening? What's the scoop? So I'm down here on the Smith and Smith show, and well, I'm here to tell jokes, and some of my better jokes have actually become, well, government legislation. But I don't want to leave you with the impression that I'm the only funny man from Ottawa. That's not the case. There are many. And I've become a great admirer of the comedy of Joe Clark, a great humorist, a great funny man, the effervescent personality we've come to know and love. Well, he told a joke a couple of months back, and it brought down the house. Thank you. And every once in a while, on a rare day, I see Joe at work, and I can't help it. I walk up to him, and I just can't help it. It goes like this. Joe, 6 months, hardly seem worthwhile, you know? Well, it really bugs him, and I like it. I like that. So people have been asking me about high inflation, high unemployment, and a sagging Canadian dollar, and what I'm going to do about it. Tough. I'm not worried about it. I've got a job. I'm doing quite well, thank you. And for the rest of you, well, come on now. You're old enough to get into your own act. People get upset when I say these little off-the-cuff remarks. They ask me, what's going on? What's happening? You know, what's the scoop? And I have to tell them that I don't know. I haven't got a clue. I stay in Ottawa, take care of the kids, run a country.
Thank you very much.
Sometime a woman has to do what she has to do, and sometime a man has to do what he has to do, but very seldom does it happen at all, if at all, that a man has to do what a woman has to do. Well, we have an understanding. Oh, yeah. I know that I am his only girl. In my heart, I know that.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
And he knows that he is my main man.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yes, I do. Yes, I do. Yes, I do. Yes, he do. Yes, we do. The both of us.
Yeah, we do.
I am his only girl.
Oh,
and he's my main man, as far as he knows. Yes, and when he holds me in his arms, oh, just so big and strong. This kind of love feels so right. I just know it can't be wrong. Oh no, oh no, oh no, oh no, oh no. It can't be wrong. And when he
puts his lips on her mind.
Push him away so quick. Push him away.
Cause he knows my love is just divine. He's with one foxy chick.
One foxy chick.
And I say, oh, give me your love,
come on, give me your love,
I want your love,
I want your love,
I need your love.
Please help us thank Althea DiGregorio and Mark Halloran.